beach bonfire party. Lay down?
Sure, yeah.
Oh, come on, I'm not actually gonna go out with him.
No, he's young, successful, and he's hot. Gross.
The last summer follows high school friends as they deal with love and friendship during their final summer together before heading off to college. It's streaming right now on Netflix, and two of the stars, Tyler Posey and Halston Sage, are here. Good morning.
Hi.
Good to see you guys.
Good to see you too.
So we were joking about this movie because it's like, oh my God, totally romantic, right here at Wrigley Field, right in Chicago.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
When I think romance, I think Wrigley Field.
What is it like playing a baseball player? I mean, every kid probably dreams of doing that, playing a major league player,
right?
Oh, it was
so cool. So, like, my dad and my brother are huge baseball fans.
Yeah.
And so I grew up around it my whole life. And I played a little bit of T-ball when I was a kid in Little League, but I found skateboarding pretty early on, and then being able to, like, put on the suit and go out and, like, choreograph like a where a pop fly goes over my head. It was the greatest.
That is awesome.
Just that cool. Jump that you do into your lap,
right.
Halston, basically. I mean, that must have been super choreographed.
A little bit,
like,
yeah.
It's like a perfect.
Because we didn't want to hurt Halston at all.
And right.
We had a stunt guy who
They're
was.
They're nice. It was a very nice set. Very thoughtful.
Yeah. But it was great, man. It was so much fun.
What was it like for you to be in iconic Wrigley Field, to be shooting at this place where Ferris Bueller and, like, so many other iconic movies have shot?
It was huge.
It really felt like movie magic. And, it was just our crew there that day. So in the movie, it looks like the whole stadium was full, but it was actually just a very small group of people, which was really an incredible experience. And we actually got to shoot inside the scoreboard, which was my favorite part, because you have this incredible view, and it was nighttime. It was actually very romantic.
It was very romantic. Extremely romantic, Romantic comedy.
There
what
Cubs
happens
fans.
In the scoreboard right. stays in the scoreboard.
Because it's on Netflix now, so you... what happens in the scoreboard goes on Netflix.
I know there are Cubs fans that would die to be able to do a picnic in Wrigley Field and be up in the scoreboard.
Yeah. It was intense.
It was really amazing. Cool.
This movie is more than just Wrigley Field.
Right.
Talk a little bit more about the premise of The Last Summer.
So The Last Summer is a really fun. It's a rom-com, which I love. I grew up watching rom-coms, so to bring that genre back is really exciting. Mm. And it's really sweet. It's about that transitional time in your life in between, being a teenager and becoming a young adult. And first love and first jobs. And it's a really exciting time and like a great movie about relationships.
Yeah, it's really adorable too, and it, like, kind of just talks about growing up and not knowing what you want to do and having that be okay, because I think it's a message that a lot of kids need to
There's
hear.
There's not enough rom-coms anymore.
There's not enough rom-coms.
I know.
I love them. And I'm like, finally, they're coming back.
One of my all-time favorites was set in Chicago, About Last Night.
Oh, my gosh. Yes. Wow. So you remember that? That was one of our all-time favorites.
Yes.
And Made in Manhattan.
Yeah.
Hello, the J-Lo one. Oh, yeah. You played J-Lo's son?
I did.
A long time ago. I don't know if we
Before
have that.
Before the beard.
We have that video.
Before the beard.
I mean, that's one of the all-time favorite rom-coms. And then you're in Teen Wolf. Everyone's
Not
huge fans
a rom-com.
Of that. Yeah. Here you are in Made rom-com. In Manhattan.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Look at you.
Oh, my God. I'm losing my mind.
Little guy.
How?
17. Oh, I love that dog.
Oh,
good puppy.
That's where you first fell in love with dogs.
That's where it started. That's right where it happened.
What was that experience like for you?
I mean, as a little kid
and working with J-Lo?
Yeah, so J-Lo was, like, really the only one that I knew at the time. And then I didn't know Stanley Tucci or Ralph Fiennes too well, But I knew that being in that elevator in the scene with them, I was around, like, these legendary actors.
Right.
I was so young. I was 10 years old, so it was kind of hard to retain everything. But I learned a lot. J-Lo was really professional, and I kind of kept that with me throughout the years, and it was the coolest. I knew how cool it was at the time. I didn't know how like big the movie was going to be,
right.
And they play it every year. And it's
always on TV.
It's always on TV.
Thank you. Yeah. It's a rom-com classic.
Yeah.
So cool. Robin brings it up like every week.
Hey, J-Lo, when are you doing another rom-com? Yeah, but this one looks good in Chicago.
Yeah.
So I heard you love 80s movies. Did your parents ram them down your throat like I ram them down my kids' throat? They hate them.
Yes. No, they hate them?
They're so old.
Yes, like, that's what mine too.
Oh, that's my favorite part. It's so nostalgic, and the music is so good.
Yeah.
There's nothing like the feeling, and of it. I don't know, just it feels like it was such a different time. It was maybe just because of the genre of the films were so light and young, but I also felt like they were very realistic depictions of like that young age and what it's like to be you know, in high school, especially at that time. And it makes me wish I was alive for it.
Yeah, we weren't alive during that time.
Well, Teen Wolf is based on the 80s Michael J. Fox Teen Wolf.
Yeah,
and that lasted, how many seasons did that last? Years?
About six, yeah. 100 episodes.
Yeah, it was a great show. There's people that were, they're like, he's coming in. Teen Wolf. It was fantastic.
So you guys back in town, are you going to go to Wrigley Field tonight?
Yeah, we are. Right. Yeah, I'm throwing out the first pitch.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. And do you guys do the seventh inning stretch too?
Yes.
We do, yeah.
Yeah.
Has anyone told you about the missteps of like an Ozzy Osbourne in the past or my
dad did show me some YouTube videos. He said, this is a very serious thing. He loves baseball. My dad's a big baseball fan, so he made sure to, you know, let me know how important it was to get it right. Oh, so I know he'll be watching.
We're going to mess up? Is it the song?
It's the song. It's like a big thing, and like you got to scream it out on the microphone.
Oh,
it's like a very
I'm going to fail.
No.
You were all good with it till we brought it up here.
That's right. We'll practice in the car.
Oh, jeez.
Last Summer is streaming on Netflix right now. It's great to have you guys here. Thank you.
Nice to meet you both.
Thank you so much.
Good to be here.